Hi, I'm Paul McDivitt. I work in communications here at University of Minnesota Extension.
And I'm Fabian Fernandez, nutrient management specialist here in the St. Paul campus of the University of Minnesota.
And today we're going to be talking about enhanced efficiency fertilizers, nitrogen inhibitors, and a lot of those other products. Fabian, why do you call nitrogen inhibitors instead of stabilizers?
Yeah, that's a good question. Nothing is really stable in nitrogen until nitrogen is transformed to N2 gas, which is 78% of what we have around us in the atmosphere. And so when we are talking about ammonium or nitrate, we are not really stabilizing them. We are just kind of keeping them in that form for a while, but they are not really stable.
What are the two main groups of nitrogen inhibitors, and what are the differences between the two?
Yeah, the two major groups are urease inhibitors, which protect nitrogen from volatilization loss, and then the others are nitrification inhibitors. Nitrification inhibitors protect nitrogen or keep nitrogen in the ammonium form so that it doesn't transform to nitrate. And the reason why we use these inhibitors is to protect nitrogen from potential loss to the environment.
And what other types of enhanced efficiency fertilizers are there?
Yeah, so there are kind of two major groups in addition to the inhibitors that we talked about, and they have to do with how this nitrogen is protected. It's either kind of a physical barrier, like a polymer coating, or biological and chemical processes that need to happen to transform nitrogen into a form that could potentially be lost. So those are the two major ways.
What are some scenarios where enhanced efficiency fertilizers make the most sense for farmers?
Those will be situations where you either are way too wet in that field, or it has extreme drainage, like a sandy soil, for instance. Those will be the situations where you have the most potential for nitrogen loss, and that's where you would want to protect nitrogen with an inhibitor. The other one would be if you're using urea and leaving it on the soil surface, especially if that surface has a lot of crop residue. That's where you would want to use a urease inhibitor.
So this has been a pretty strange winter in Minnesota, a strange spring now. Should corn growers in Minnesota use enhanced efficiency fertilizers this year?
Yes, I think it is important. Again, it's an investment to protect your larger investment, which is nitrogen fertilizer, and so being judicious in terms of where you apply these inhibitors is extremely important. So basically, put those inhibitors where you have the biggest potential to get a return on that investment.
What about sidedress applications? Does it make sense to use an inhibitor with those?
Sidedress applications typically are done at the time when the crop is already taking up nitrogen and water, so the potential for nitrogen loss through leaching or denitrification is a lot lower, so I would not use a nitrification inhibitor, but I would use a urease inhibitor. For instance, if you're applying urea and leaving it on the soil surface without the ability to incorporate with tillage, it would be a situation where I would use a urease inhibitor.
What tips do you have for inhibitor economics?
Using an inhibitor is not an excuse to do poor nitrogen management. You have to do the best possible management that you can and use these enhancers to protect your investment. And so, for instance, if you apply nitrogen way too early and you use a nitrification inhibitor, well, that inhibitor will protect your investment for a little bit of time, but probably not long enough for that to have an effect when you actually really need that nitrogen.
Why is it important to watch the forecast before you apply urea and a urease inhibitor?
A urease inhibitor protects that nitrogen from volatilization loss potential for a few days. It doesn't, you know, keep it indefinitely. And so if you're leaving that fertilizer on the surface, even with a urease inhibitor, you want that nitrogen to move into the root zone as soon as possible. And so if you can apply it ahead of a rain event, that can help protect that investment.
Fabian, can you explain to us what products we have here?
Yeah, so we have urea, which is just a straight nitrogen fertilizer, 46% nitrogen. This one is ammonium sulfate, which has nitrogen and sulfur. And the benefit of this one is not an inhibitor or anything, but it does protect nitrogen from volatilization loss, so it could be safely applied on the soil surface. This one is agrotane, which is urea with a urease inhibitor, and this will be something that you would want to use when you leave this product on the soil surface for a few days without incorporation. Super U is one where you have two inhibitors. You have a urease inhibitor to protect nitrogen from volatilization loss, but it also has a nitrification inhibitor, so it keeps nitrogen in the ammonium form for a while. This is a kind of newer product, Envol, and this is a combination of MBPT and duramide, and both of these are for they're urease inhibitors, so they protect nitrogen from volatilization loss when you leave them on the soil surface. And then this last one is ESN, it's a polymer-coated urea, so it's not an inhibitor, but it has a coating that keeps urea in the urea form for a while before it starts to release into the soil.
Where can growers learn more about nitrogen fertilizer products?
Well, at the University of Minnesota Extension website at z.umn.edu/nitrogen.